Hello and welcome to the 31st video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how you can plan and design for your video presentation in After Effects. Now, creating video presentations can be complex and time-consuming. I always find it helps to have a plan before jumping into After Effects as it gives me something to work to. Once you know or have a rough idea of what you're creating, it's a lot more fun putting it together rather than making it up as you go along. Now, before I start any project in After Effects, I typically take a little time to plan and design my video presentation. This will typically include the following steps. 1. Project preparation and checklist. 2. Planning the structure. 3. Planning my timeline. 4. Storyboarding, and 5. Designing my artwork in Photoshop. In this video, I'll be discussing these steps and how I plan and design a video presentation and offer some tips which I hope will help you. So before I start any video project, I typically start with step 1, project preparation. So this is a quick step I undertake to make sure I have everything I need to undertake a project and ensure I have thought everything through. To do this, I use a project prep and checklist sheet. So this is a sheet I have prepared earlier and I use this at the very start of each project. First, I recap on the project and write a quick project description. Now, if you already have a brief, you can take your information from there, but sometimes I like to break it down and make some minor notes of reference to come back to as I develop my project. Next, I'll write any notes I need to keep in mind, and then I go through an asset list to make sure I have everything I need to start a project. Before I start any project, I will make sure I have all the assets I need to include in the presentation, such as graphics, video, audio, or any typefaces. Now, I generally don't start any project until I have all these boxes ticked. Once I'm happy with this, I will move on to the next step. Step 2, planning the structure. So next, I will give some thought to the overall video presentation. To do this, I use another sheet I have prepared earlier. Before starting a video presentation, I like to have a rough idea of how I'm going to structure a presentation and what I'm going to develop. Now, this may not be the final outcome, but it's an initial guide to work from. Here, I will ask myself questions like, will I create the presentation in sections? Will I include any animated video or image sequences? Will the video be in sync to music? And are there any logo idents I need to include? As I think about this, I will plan my structure on this sheet and make any further notes to keep in mind. Once I'm happy with this, I will move on to the next step. Step 3, planning my timeline. So once I have thought through the structure of my presentation, I can start to visualize the structure and think about how this may take shape over a timeline. To do this, I use another sheet I have prepared earlier. This is simply a blank sheet with some lines which I can sketch down some thoughts. Here I can plan how I want to structure the presentation over time in sections. So once I'm happy with this, I will move on to the next step. Step 4, storyboarding. So once I have thought through my timeline, I can start to design how my presentation may look. To do this, I use several sheets I have prepared earlier. These are frame boxes printed on a few pages in a variety of sizes. Now, I use these sheets to bring the timeline plan to life and start to visualize how each key section may look. Now, I typically sketch out some layouts if I have initial thoughts and ideas. Once I'm happy with this, I will move on to the last step. Step 5, designing my artwork in Photoshop. So during the storyboard stage, I will sketch and think about how I may want my presentation to look. After this stage, I will start to bring my initial sketches to life and design everything in Photoshop. This is a way to prepare all my layouts and artwork and get everything ready to put together in After Effects. Now, in this process, I may prepare lots of images, typography, and graphics I will later bring into After Effects. Now, I generally spend quite a lot of time on this process, getting this right before I take everything into After Effects and animate. So those are my 5 key steps I take before I even start in After Effects. Now, to help you with your process, I have provided these planning sheets in the downloadable project folder. With the project folder open, click into the S3 Create a Project folder, into folder 31, Plan and Design, into the Planning Sheets folder, And in this folder, you will find blank templates for the project prep and checklist, project structure, timeline sheet, and the storyboard sheet. Now, if you print these out, you will be able to use them in your video presentation design process. Now, if you don't have the project folder and you want to access these planning sheets I have prepared especially for you, you can download the project folder for a small fee. The download link with instructions is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. So let's now take a quick look at how I use this plan and design process for the project we are about to create. So with the project folder open, click into the S3 Creative Project folder, into folder 31, Plan and Design, into the first folder, Plan and Design, and you will see the same documents I just demonstrated, though with my workings. Now, if you have access to a printer, I would recommend printing these out, as we are going to be referring back to these as we progress through this section of the course. If you can't print, just make sure you have them to hand ready to look at as I refer to them. So first, come and open Sheet 1, Project Prep and Checklist. So this is a scan of my Project Prep and Checklist. Here are some notes I have taken down before starting my project. So the project title is London Top 5, and the duration needs to be around 1 minute. For the project description, I have noted, create a 2D advert for a travel blog showcasing 5 top venues to visit in London. The presentation will need to run the duration of the audio file which has been provided, and ideally the video sequence will run in sync with the audio. So this is something I will need to keep in mind when creating my presentation. For my notes, I have destinations are Hyde Park, the Aquarium, Shoreditch, Camden Town, and Tower of London. Graphics are provided, but you will need to create additional artwork to build the presentation. So this is the main criteria I need to keep in mind. For my asset checklist, I can check off everything, as I have received them and have them all ready to use. So next, come back into the project folder and this time open project structure. So here I am thinking about possible sections for the video. Now the video is about the 5 destinations to visit in London. So already there are some clear sections I can structure my presentation with. To this, I want to include an introduction section and an outro section. So from my initial thoughts, I will have around 7 sections to my video presentation. For each, I have given some thought as to what they will be. The introduction will be an animation, the 5 destination sections will be video or image edits, and the outro section will be an animation. For notes, I have written, keep in mind that I will need to somehow sync the sections to the music provided. Listen to the music and see if there are any ways I can sync each section up. So next, come back into the project folder and this time open timeline sheet. So here I have taken the blank sheet I showed earlier and planned a timeline based on the previous project structure. Here I am thinking about the 7 sections I just established and how they might work on a timeline and what I may include. So on the timeline, we can see 7 clear sections, which I can organize my video into. For the introduction, I'm thinking about creating an animated sequence with typography and images. For the Hyde Park section, I'm thinking of creating a video edit of clips and images with type on top. And if this formula works, I will apply it to the other destination sections. And for the outro section, I will create an animated sequence to finish the presentation. So with this initial timeline plan, I can now start to think about how my presentation may look. So next, come back into the project folder and this time come into the storyboarding folder and open storyboard overview. So this is a quick idea and a really rough sketch of how some of the frames can work. This is based off the previous timeline sheet I created. And here I have used the same colors for the sections. Here we can see section 1 through to 7, and here I have thought about what I may include on each keyframe. For the intro, I am thinking of 3 frames. Frame 1 will state 5 top places, frame 2 will state to visit in, and frame 3 will state London. For the next frames, I have thought about maybe having the destination title in bold and then including some type beneath it. So once I have a rough outline like this, I then spend a bit of time thinking more about the details of the layouts. So next, come back into the project folder and this time open the next PDF. Number 2, storyboard. So here I have taken the previous storyboard sketch a little further and started to think about each keyframe visually. Here I have thought about section 1, 2 and 7. So if I zoom in here, for section 1, I'm thinking of starting with a map in the background and using some destination pin graphics. This will lead onto the next frame where we will build up to London on top of the British flag. So coming down to section 2, here I have thought about starting this section with a destination icon with a number. This would lead into an image or video where the type destination will appear on top in bold typography. And then this would lead onto a frame where the title pans up to reveal the description copy below. This will then lead onto the next sections. Though here I have not drawn out the frames for my other sections as I want them to follow the same formula as seen here for section 2. And lastly, I finish with section 7. After all the destination sections, I want to end with an animation that starts with simple bold type, and then an illustration that builds up and appears underneath. So once I'm happy with my initial planning and storyboarding, it is now time for me to start to design and build the layouts in Photoshop. So next, come back into the project folder and this time come into the design folder and open the project design Photoshop file. So here I am in Photoshop, and this is where I took all my storyboard sketches and brought them to life. So if we look over in the layers panel, you can see I have folders and each is named with the sections 1 through to 7 I planned previously. Now, I suggest you have a little look around in here and see how I have prepared my layouts. This is very typical of the type of document I will prepare before I even get into After Effects. Before I jump into After Effects, I like to think carefully about every element and design it just how I want it. So when it comes to building my presentation in After Effects, I have done the hardest part, and all I have to do is simply build it in After Effects. So in each folder, I have carefully designed the layout of each section from my storyboard. So in the first folder, 1, Introduction, if we toggle this down, inside I have frame 1, 2 and 3, which again is a reference to my storyboard. So right now we are looking at the very first frame, which is the same frame I initially sketched. Here I have my type, the pins and the map background. This is the look and feel I want to create in my video presentation. Now during my design process, I chose to include round pins instead of the square pins as I thought that would look a little better. My idea here is to have these pins animate in at the start as the type animates in. So next is frame 2, and here I'm going with another color, and then frame 3. So looking at my storyboard, here I wanted the type to be placed on a British flag. So here I have composed how I want that to work. My idea here is to have all these flag shapes animate in so it has a nice dynamic effect. I think this would look pretty cool if I can achieve that. So the next folder above is Hyde Park. So if I toggle the visibility of this folder and toggle down the folder, we have 3 frames. Again, referencing the storyboard I created earlier. So first we have a number pin, and this is how I want that to look. My idea here is to have the pin bounce down just before we move on to the next frame. I think this would look pretty cool if I can do that. So this is how I see the frames building up for the destination sections. The type will sit on top of a background image or video edit. Now, I think if these bars were to animate in, this would look pretty cool. Now, the same goes with the other sections. For these, I want to use the same formula throughout. So if you look into each folder, you will see the same layout. Though what I have done differently is change the color of the number pins at the start of each section. So it goes red, blue, red, blue, and so on. So finally, the last section, section 7, the outro section. So on the storyboard, I wanted the type to appear and then some buildings animate in below. So back in Photoshop, for frame 1, we can see the type. And here I have decided to include the pin as part of the type, as it's become a bit of a theme throughout the video. And then onto frame 2, which would build up into a scene with lots of London buildings below, just like my storyboard sketch. Now, during my design process here in Photoshop, I chose to include some clouds here for added visual effect. Now, my idea here for this composition is to have a few things animate. I'd like the clouds to animate in and move across the sky. I'd like the helicopter to fly across the sky, the London buses to move across the bridge, and the London Eye to rotate around. If I can achieve this, this might look pretty cool. So this is my design I have in store for the video presentation. Like I said earlier, I typically spend a lot of time in Photoshop designing my layouts, graphics, and visual style before getting into After Effects. Once I am happy I have everything covered, it is now time to get into After Effects and start to bring the whole presentation to life. So this whole process of planning and design starts with simple ideas and builds into visual solutions, which I can create in After Effects. Now, this is a method I always use as it encourages me to really think about what I am doing. It makes something that at first appears complex and difficult just that little easier to manage. Now, you don't have to undertake this process, though I would recommend it as it really works for me. So once we have a good idea of what we want to create, it's now time to jump into After Effects and make a start. In the next video, we are going to start by setting up our document in After Effects and preparing our project folder. So see you in the next video.